हाँ जी, सो आई थिंक वी हैव 129 स्टूडेंट्स नाउ, कैन आई एडमिट देम
ओह
ऑल?
ग्रेट,
थैंक्स कैप्टन गजानन, अनऑफिशियली लेट मी थैंक यू एंड कैप्टन वेस्ट फॉर मेकिंग इट ओवर हियर एट शॉर्ट नोटिस, एंड रियली इट
यस,
विल बी एनलाइटनिंग फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स एक्चुअली सी फेयरर्स. सो
ओह
129
यस, वी ऑल आर सी फेयरर्स
या
फर्स्ट.
ऑल सी फेयरर्स, एट लीस्ट दैट मीन लाइव्स यू आर गोइंग टू सेव एंड दैट मीन एक्शंस यू आर गोइंग टू प्रिवेंट. थैंक यू सर. सो आई जस्ट who is the host co-host, please admit the students.
Admit all, okay. Admit all.
Yeah. पीला पीला ये पसंद तो मेरा काम कर
पीला
कार्ड
गुड आफ्टरनून सर. गुड
आफ्टरनून,
गुड आफ्टरनून सर.
गुड आफ्टरनून,
गुड आफ्टरनून सर.
गुड आफ्टरनून,
हां गुड आफ्टरनून सर.
Good afternoon. I think it's .201. So we should start. Welcome to you, each of you. First of all, let me welcome Captain Gajanan, who is here, and Captain Umesh Oak. Both of them, welcome to you both, sir.
Thank
this
you.
Process was initiated just a few days back when I was just speaking to Captain Gajanan, who is basically the president of All India Marine Pilot Associations. So I was just discussing with him, and he had fantastic ideas to him, where he was saying that so many accidents are happening across. We have been hearing the first step which a person goes on board, right, from a pilot. I think when accidents you hear and people passing away, we had even very senior people who just lost their lives in recent past, who have been doing this day in, day out. But then I think this was the thought process with which we started, and then thanks to Captain Gajanan who initiated this particular process. And I'll just not take much time. I'll introduce Captain Gajanan. He's not a stranger to me, at least as HIMT. I know him since the days of Marketer, when I think he was getting placements to our cadets who were there. And thereafter, he has been with SICAL. And he's also quite active in various parts. You must be seeing various articles from him in various magazines, from Sagar Sandesh to Marex, everywhere I think we could see his articles, and including online. So Captain Gajanan is a master mariner and he is the president of All India Marine Pilot Association in the advisory council of HPR, that is USA. His blue economy is what I was picking across, which is the thing which is coming as articles in various leading publications. He's a social activist, a writer. He's an ex-coach, he's a guest speaker, and also a metamorphosis leader. So welcome to you, Captain Gajanan, over to you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon, HMITians, I must call, to you all, students of second mates, mates and masters. Thank you, Captain. Thank you, Sanjeev Vakil, sir. I mean, he's been always a source of inspiration for all of us in fraternity. And he always comes with a lot of flood of energy. When he decides something, he doesn't listen to himself as well. So he's the kind of that person you have as a mentor of mentors in HIMT and as well as in fraternity. Thank you very much for this opportunity. I would also thank Principal Anand Subramaniam for this beautiful lecture that we have been given the opportunity to discuss. My name is Captain Gajanan Karanjikar. I am a president of All India Maritime Pilots Association. Now, this is a very special class what we are conducting. This is the 8th institute we are doing this class now. And the theme behind this class is very simple: to ensure the safety of life. I mean, solars is everywhere in our life. Even cross the road, we use solars to cross the road. So when that kind of thought process mariners have, so we saw a very serious lacuna in pilot ladders during our surveys in Indian ports, the vessel calling Indian ports. And that time we thought that something must be done about it, because the pilot, when he boards the vessel, definitely he briefs the crew as to what is wrong in tying pilot ladder or what is wrong in the pilot ladder. But then that is only 2, 3, 5, or 6 crew. The mass education never happens. So idea, we took this to the MPIs, to the students, to the second mates, mates and masters. Why mates? Because mates are the responsible people for this safety equipment, because the pilot ladder is a part of the safety equipment certificate, Form E. And of course, master is the overall in charge of safety. So that's why we took this subject to them. We also did a classes for ratings, classes for PC cadets, to exactly train them, teach them as to how do you tie a pilot ladder. Because we saw initially that a lot of pilot ladders were supplied new by the companies to the vessels, but the onboard crew did not know how to tie them up. The correct procedure of tying pilot ladder is very important. And because the person who's climbing the pilot ladder, he may not be a pilot alone. He may be a surveyor, he may be a harbor master, he may be a colleague who's coming to relieve you on board, ship's crew, and also other people on board coming by pilot ladder. When they start to climb the pilot ladder, they trust you. They trust the crew members on board that the pilot ladder is correctly tied. I'll tell you an example. Recent accident in Mumbai port. The pilot started to climb pilot ladder and the entire pilot ladder fell down. 4-5 meter pilot ladder, entire pilot ladder fell on the pilot. So in this scenario, I mean, we can blame crew. Very easy to blame crew. But what do we do about it? So AMPA, as a All India Maritime Pilot Association, did a lot of activism. We spoke to governments, we spoke to MOUs, we asked them to do a concentrated inspection. We asked PSC to detain ships which are not doing these procedures properly. But then somewhere, when you think constructively, the pilots have to come forward and teach people, because it's their life also. So taking this, you know, kind of a baton forward, we roped in Captain Oak, who himself is a, you know, he's been a lecturer, been a mentor, been a pilot, been a dock master now, as a right guy to explain you all as to what the pilot ladder means, what is the pilot ladder, how to tie pilot ladder, and what is the pilot transfer procedure. So the pilot transfer procedure is that effectively transferring the pilot from pilot boat to the vessel. When that happens, the pilot transfer is complete. So Captain Oak is there at the moment with us today. He is, a very senior person today. He's become a master in 2000, where from 2003 to 2006, he was in Tolani Institute. Thereafter 2006 onwards, he was, he joined as a pilot in Mumbai port. And last 2 years, he's been a dock master. He also has been a lecturer in SBLBS College before. So by way of Captain Oak, teaching you all today the procedures of pilot ladder, we have in him a lecturer, we have in him a pilot, and we have in him a dock master who's arranging for pilots now and, you know, monitoring the entire pilot operation. It is important for you all to understand the other side of the view, because we always have, I'm a seafarer myself, he's also a seafarer, but we always look at the ship view as to how does the pilot ladder look from my ship. We don't see how it is perceived from outside. When pilot comes to the pilot boat to board the vessel, in 5 minutes, he'll make out what kind of crew is on board. In 5 minutes, looking at the ship side, he knows what company is this. And with the pilot ladder, he knows what kind of crew is there on board. So this is the first impression kind of stuff, you know, which we present to somebody else outside the ship. So I would definitely like you guys to pay undivided attention to this lecture, because this lecture has been arranged to you painstakingly by the Association of Pilots to save lives. I'm sure every one of us, every one of you all, second mate, mates and masters, today 140 people we are there, barring 10 instructors, 130 students. I want to ensure and guarantee Captain Oak and to fraternity that after this lecture, 130 ships will be saved in pilot ladder. And we will save many lives. We are losing every year 2 to 3 lives of pilots in the world in fatal accidents and many injuries. You won't believe. I mean, pilot, at the moment, there are 3 pilots in India who are incapacitated for last 4 weeks because of pilot ladder injury. And one of them is for 8 weeks now. So such are the injuries. The pilots have their families and they have to go back home. Anybody who boards the family, boards the ship, has to go back to his family like you all. So your act has to be absolutely, you know, correct to ensure that the person goes back home who climbs the ladder. I thank you all for this, and please pay attention to Captain Oak's lecture now. I would hand over the floor to Captain Oak.
Thank you, Captain Karanikar. I thank first of all to total staff, Mr. Sanjeev Vakil, Captain Anand, and all other supporting staff of HIFT. And I thank you all also to be eager to know or learn more things. And as they say, you have to catch them young. So since you all have just started your career, so it will be better to mold you right now instead of once you get your actual certificates and so on. So I thank you all. And also I thank all these 14 years seafarers, our colleagues, because of which even after 10,000 of pilot ladder climbing up and down, I'm still alive to tell you the stories. So obviously you must be wondering, am I bullshitting or no? So it's not the thing. I really must have climbed not less than 10,000 ships for the last 14 years. Per day, you can say 6 ships. So every ship 30 meters up and 30 meters down. So let's come back to the point. You as a seafarer from the ship, we always, like when my cadetship started, the first thing when I encountered the pilot ladder, the way it has to be lowered and rigged and heaved up in the ballast condition, that is, believe me, to be honest, that is the job I ever hated in my life. And on top of it, on the first day, chief mate told me, look, see it properly. If there is any accident, you will be behind the bars. So I was shocked. I said, sir, I am only a cadet. Then he gave one of the F words and he said, do you want to remain cadet for your life? So climb up the ladder. So you go second mate, third mate, second mate, mate, and then the masters. So of course, I never thought I'll be stepping on the ladders ever. Because the way I have seen from the ship the pilot's life, I thought, oh, who will do these close quarters every day in and out and middle of the night, climbing very 30 meters up. But as the luck would have it, I happened to be landed here. So anyway, what I'm doing is I'll share my screen and I will share my couple of PPTs with you. To start with, I have made one small PPT just to, many of you might be inquisitive, like what is pilot's day like? How he must be going, doing, what all things he's doing. So it was basically meant for the pre-sea cadets so that they can have some fair ideas to how sea looks like and all that. But as Captain Karanjikar suggested me, might as well, you can share here also. So I'll be doing that. So if anybody has any doubts also in between with Mr. Sanjeev Vakil's permission, you can raise the questions, no issues, or we will tackle it towards the end of the PPT.
Yeah, Captain Anand, that you would like to say some rules, how do you want to take it up, Captain Anand?
Yes. I think it's better that we will keep the questions for the end so that there is no distraction or disruption in between. Yes, sir.
Can you see my screen now, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I'll be starting from here. This is, of course, very fascinating view from my quarters, which is close to the port only. And that's the Bombay port. Here you can see the Sassoon dock. So now I'll just share with you the how pilot day starts. So here the pilot day starts. You can see the very important equipment. Either it starts from the taking ship out. This is one of the passenger ships which I had started taking out in the morning. And need not to elaborate the importance of this particular equipment here, without which we are without. Yeah, and anybody?
Sir, cannot hear you. You are muted.
Is it okay now? Now it's okay. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. So this is the day starting, and let me just go to the next slide. Yeah, the day starts sometimes with beautiful sunrise. It ends by a beautiful sunset. Of course, we as a pilot in Bombay, we work 24 hours. So at times you get a beautiful full moon night. Also rough weather during the monsoon seasons. It can be even rainy day. As you can see, this is a very rare picture. Only on the ships we can see really the rain is approaching. The shore people cannot enjoy this type of views. So you can see the precipitation in the sight and rain is heavily approaching towards the ship. Suddenly visibility will be zero. It's one of the sunny days, and this is a pilot oak ready to go out. I have my own vehicle. I mean, it is belong to port, but just like as we travel to offices, I travel in my pilot launch. So one more point over here. I don't want to embarrass you by asking the flag hotel. So this is the hotel. Since wind is not there, it is not flying high. So this is the way we go out for the picking up pilot. Sometimes we directly go out from the ship and disembark and board next ship. I'll just quickly go through. There can be tankers, there can be bulk carriers. Here you can see the very peculiar problem of bulk carrier, especially when you are carrying coal or something. The area near the pilot ladder is absolutely dirty. And just before pilot comes, some good idea of mate, he washes the deck down, and the whole black color comes on the pilot ladder. So when pilot is climbing up, his white sparkling uniform gets colorful or rather black. So be careful of this also. Here I would like to tell you that you can see there are a couple of bulk carriers here, 1, 2, 3, 4. So with looking at the picture, you can imagine how close they are. So in port, because of the restrictions on the areas, the even big bulk carriers are marginally placed together, just about 180 meters, 200 meters. So ASM people, when you're going for ship handling and all, it is very important to assess the distance between the ships. But of course, you have to have your own assessment also. So many times I have seen experienced masters also, they have their apprehensions. So I have to explain them that this is the port requirement and you can't have a liberty of having at least half a mile clearance from everybody. So that type of liberty you have at the outer roads when you are anchoring. So in ports, pilot has to be have very precise anchorage, very precise maneuvers. So he's always worked up, and like that he will be disembarking and embarking on various ships. Suddenly the ship will be LPG. It can be a tanker. It can be a bulk carrier. Here you can see the oil rig also, which has come for the maintenance. So it can be one of the cold moves. Now this oil rig is put her legs inside the water and she is stationary here. But when she goes out, she will have at least 3 tugs. So you can imagine as a cold move when you are handling any craft or any such rig with 3 different tugs and you are only on front tug. So how difficult it can be. This is one of the Suezmax. You can see the center lead and center gyro repeater. Here I would like to emphasis on one thing, that on big vessels, we'll find that there are two arrangements to lower the pilot ladder, depending upon your freeboard, because a combination ladder can be reaching at different heights. And as per regulation, as you know, pilot is not supposed to climb more than, I mean, less than 1.5 by ladder and more than 9 meters. So that is how you have that regulation of 1.5 meter to 9 meter, you can have a pilot ladder. The other details will be anyway seeing further. It can be a beautiful passenger ship also. You can see the entrance here. The passenger ship is the best ship to handle also and to climb also, because their pilot boarding arrangements is as close as the water level. Sometimes with the pilot launch freeboard, we can just step in also. So this is the one of the passenger ships coming to Bombay, and that is the same boarding of that on that ship only. This has taken from inside. Now you can see the water is very close by. So there sometimes from the pilot ladder, we can just step onto the deck also. Here I am purposely not wearing life jacket, because one of you may have doubt ki why pilot is not wearing life jacket. So we take some liberty because we are hanging around with the pilot life jacket during rainy seasons. It can be raincoat, helmet, and the walkie-talkie popping out from the bag. So it sometimes becomes cumbersome to handle all this. So we take a liberty. If the freeboard and all is less, I just don't use it. But here you can see the ship's crew who has come to receive me. Even they are having their safety harness. Of course, on the cargo ships and tankers, we don't have that type of arrangement separately. But especially on the accommodation ladder, when the bosun or officer comes to receive pilot, he should have this harness, because that the very small space, and plus you are hanging overside. So the harness is very important. And here, of course, because of the freeboard and all, the pilot ladder is hanging from the top. It is not fixed over here near the, or rather lashed over near the deck. So this is one of the pictures I had boarded that time. Again, it can be a tanker. It can be a sunset when this type of things also re-energize you while doing pilotage. And it's really, you can enjoy that pilotage also at times. And at times you get the early day off because of less traffic. Then pilot is back on the way and he lands up ashore. Now this is something you can see. Here there is a step here. These are the steps which can be used when there is a high water, so that he can just climb up. Or there are proper masonry steps which pilot launch will come alongside and pilot will be disembarking. So this is one of the PPT. Just to show you one example of how the pilot from the ladder or from the pilot launch looks like. Here you can see the pilot going out. That is myself. Little sunny weather, but choppy sea. And you can see the background pilot launch VHF talking with the control and taking further orders and so on. You can see the choppy sea over there, and imagine same situation in the middle of the night. It is raining also outside, and you can see few ships at anchor and so on. I'll go to next slide where I'll be talking about actual rules, regulation. I'm not going deep into it, but just to sum up. So you had seen that pilot launch and pilot going out for the boarding or whatever. So here, I would like to mention that, I missed out something. There are two pilot ladder arrangements. I mean, from the two various places where you can lower the pilot ladder because of the freeboard. Because if it is a very high freeboard, then when the accommodation ladder is lowered down, it reaches away from the actual pilot ladder. And that is where you require another closer point where the pilot ladder has to be shifted to that, so that the combination ladder and pilot ladder will be tied up together and it will be firmly resting. So these are basically problems on the big vessels, that is Suezmax and other vessels. This is, of course, I'll go quickly through. These are the steps and twine and everything which you are lucky enough that you don't have to make the pilot ladder on board. We are the persons of era where we have to make the pilot ladder on board. But because of human errors and all, now it is regulated that it will not be done. It will be made ashore. But still, that doesn't stop you from knowing the dimensions, because you are the one as a final end user. So you should be knowing what it is. So as we know that thing which we don't use personally, we generally tend to neglect. So same thing is with pilot ladder, because it is lying up on the deck, open to or exposed to weather, all kind of weather. I need not to explain what all kind of weathers you have experienced. But there can be seas, there can be snow, there can be bright sunlight, like in Gulf, if you go morning 8 o'clock, it is 32-35 degrees. So you can imagine what all things are happening to that pilot ladder ropes, which are basically Manila rope. So we have to be careful, and these are the things which we have in idea that to elaborate and appraise everyone so that they appreciate the problem on the other side. So pilot ladder, of course, as you know, it is as per SOLAS Chapter 5, Regulation 23, and IMO Assembly 1045 of 27th Assembly. So these are the minimum standards. Anything above this will be always welcome, but these are the basic minimum it has to be followed. So there is also amendment that is of 29th Assembly, where it talks about the separation between the handrails. I'll be showing you a couple of pictures later. So handrails, bulwark. Bulwark is something probably second mates may not be remembering or knowing, rather. So bulwarks are basically the railings only, sort of railings, but they are seen mostly on the cargo ships and the container ships. Mostly in tankers and bulk carriers, the ship sides are having only railings of various heights. So those bulwarks where you have either opening or the pilot has to come right up to the bulwark and board. So there you have got this step ladder. Many of you might have seen or come across. The step ladder is of aluminium type, and it has to reach, that is 1.2 meters above the bulwark, so that when pilot boards, he can hold on to it. This is the picture of a bulwark. You can see the solid plate only as the ship side, I mean on the railing side. This is the plate where the separate hinge door is not arranged. So here you require ladder, aluminium ladder, which I was talking about. And these are the stanchions which pilot will come after he comes right up to that point, and then he will step down. So these ladders also has to be firmly fixed. Many times heavy crew members, they think it is isme kuch kya hoga, main pair rakh ke rakhta hu. So it has been done on even for pilot ladder. So assuming that he can hold the pilot's weight. So these are the second picture you can see. This is the bulwark where it has got opening. So it is a hinged door here. And as per regulation, the door has to be opened inward. That is from the inside the ship and not going overboard or other side of the ship. Then it is also the pilot ladder requirement is also as per ISO 799-2004. And very important point here of ISN, the most, the ISN, though it is in place or in force, but we tend to overlook few things, especially pilot ladder or deck equipments and such things. So this can be one of the points where ship can be detained or there can be a NC. So it requires a regular inspection. I'll be showing you next couple of slides. I will show you what inspection means. That means which all points as a officer, especially chief officer, because he will be the one who is responsible for all deck equipments. I hope you know what all your present responsibilities as such. I mean, who is responsible for what? Overall, of course, it is a teamwork, but still the responsibilities has to be designated so that there is no ambiguity, because especially human nature is to dump something else, something to somebody else's head, you know. To avoid that, the duties are specified. Now the IMO circular also about 1428. So strict attention to be paid to the any given time. These letters are free board. So free board is very important, because as you have seen, suppose pilot is boarding in the night in the rough weather, the video which you have seen. Now he is trying to communicate in that rolling and pitching conditions. The ship is dark. You can, you know, the only searchlight you have is in the bridge wing, which is not so much sufficient, and on most of the time it is not properly focused either. So with all this, pilot has disembarked from one outbound ship. Now he is boarding you. Suddenly he comes closer, and then he puts his flashlight or torch on it, and he finds, oh God, the ladder is 2 meters above, or rather 3 steps above. Then he will tell you, okay, Captain, I cannot board because the ladder is 3 meters high. I mean, 3-4 steps high. Now you being on the deck, you obviously will curse as to why he's asking now all such a big ladder to lower by another 3 steps. Why can't he just do some gimmick and come up? But that cannot be done, because it is after all his life as well. So now you can imagine the plight of master, who is already reached the pilot station. Now where thereafter there is a narrow channel or narrow passage. He is not well versed with this one. On top of it, pilot will always tell him, okay, Captain, when the launch is alongside, please stop engines. Because that is a customary and very important point, that when pilot launch is alongside, or rather when pilot steps on the ladder, the engines has to be stopped. Because should something happens, as you know, the ladders are quite either midship for tankers, but in other cases, they are much closer to the accommodation. The first thing pilot will be, he will get sucked into the propeller. So as a prudent masters, even pilot doesn't tell you, you should appreciate his flight. And if he forgets or something like that, make sure that you continue. Because if you stop engines at that slow speed, there is another maneuvering problem, is that ship doesn't steer. The ASM people will appreciate it more. And then the master gets panicked, because now he says, no, I'm losing steering. On the sides, on the two sides of the channel, there are ships anchored close by. So he doesn't want to lose his steering. So in spite of pilot telling, he will still continue with dead slow. So that's why it is always prudent to continue dead slow till the time pilot is about to board the step. So then you can just stop it. So even if he falls, it will take some time before he falls, if at all he falls. And meanwhile, your propeller will be off, or rather stopped. Then there are unified interpretations also about the regulations of the pilot ladder, the safe and convenient access. As you know, there will be 3 parts we can discuss about. The access at the deck level, so that is when the pilot boards on the deck, how should be the access, or what should be the clearance there, and how the pilot ladder should be spreaded. In many cases, like container ships and all, you have hardly any margin to play around there, because deck platings are so close. Immediately the combing starts, then in middle of the night, crew being tired too much. So they'll just somehow rig the ladder. The remaining ladder will be piled up there near the deck only, close by to the stowing point. So that becomes the hurdle, and that should not be the case. So I'm not going through full interpretations. So basically it is about the heights and spacings and all that. Then the second part comes is your accommodation ladder. Again, the accommodation ladder heights and all are fixed. You cannot have fully accommodation ladder lowered up to the water level. When I was initially a cadet, I used to think, why to put this very heavy pilot ladder? Why can't he just board by accommodation? It can reach right up to water, even in can go inside the water also. So, but of course, later on, as you get educated, you realize the importance of various things. So then I got enlightened that yes, pilot ladder can pitch and roll, and it can damage the gangway directly. So in all circumstances, pilot ladder, I mean the accommodation gangway cannot be lowered less than 5 meters of a distance from the water level. This is reversed. About accommodation ladder, we talk, it should be lowered so that pilot doesn't climb more than 9.5 meter vertically. And here in this case, you cannot give. Many times it happens if you are alongside for sailing and all, and sea is calm, then pilot prefers to climb directly by gangway. So he says, okay, just lower it up to water level, about 2 meters, and I'll climb up. So like that it can be. There are amendments also, SOLAS amendments 2015. Then the attached ladder to the hull in the combination ladder, which is another important point. You can imagine now when the pilot is stepping on the ladder from the water level, you know, there are 4 rubber steps and the 5th is the spreader. Now you must be wondering then why 5th only? Why not 6? Why not 7? Why not 3? So the important aspect here is the pilot ladder at the water level has to rest on the firmly on the ship side. And this job is done by the pilot crew who are helping pilot to climb. So obviously the 4th step, that is the spreader, is roughly about man's height. So they hold on to those 2 spreaders and the remaining 3-4 steps remain firmly on the ship side. Because when pilot first steps on the ladder, with that type of length of ladder, you must have learned pendulum and all, I don't want to go into that detail. So with pilot's weight, first the ladder goes away. And then slowly or violently the pilot steps bang on the ship side. So that is the first indication that pilot has stepped. Because many times when freeboard is high, the person standing on the deck cannot make out. But here there is another point I want to emphasize, that the bosun, or for that matter the junior officer who has come to receive pilot, has to go down at the lowermost platform of the accommodation ladder, so that he can immediately see what is happening or what is not happening. And that is why the communication and everything has to be very, very important. Each and every steps has to be conveyed. Means now the launch is alongside, now the launch is, now the pilot is climbing up and so on. So small commentary sort of thing has to be conveyed. So even master is comfortable, you know, once he says, yeah, okay, he has come on the combination ladder, he can use his engines for further maneuver, so dead slow and all, so that he can continue with the steering. So these are the few arrangements nowadays which has come up to keep the accommodation ladder intact or fixed with the ship side. Because as you know, the pilot ladder, it has got few arrangements which can keep the pilot steps firmly on the ship side. But gangway, what happens to gangway? The gangway keeps swinging with the wind also, and as it is, she's hanging on the only wires. So that swinging of the bottom platform and total ladder, that you must have noticed when pilot transfers himself from the pilot ladder onto the gangway, with his one leg on the gangway goes away. And to avoid this, because this will come to him as a shock. So the gangway is firmly secured. Here you can see it is a blue box called blue vacuum box. So it has got the arrangement of deck air connection. And then you can have this knob, bob wall type, which is presently in the closed position. If I would have been in college, I would have asked which is the open position. So here I will only disclose that if you make it parallel, that is vertical, the valve is open. So deck air connection is given. These 2 handles can be held by the ship's crew and it will be resting on the ship side. This deck air will create a vacuum in the equipment, and like a lizard, it will stick to the ship side. I'll show you the further photo also. And this is the eye where you have to tie up your gangway, that is accommodation gangway. These pilot ladders at that level can be tied up with this one of the flush bars which are welded in the ship side. So there you can tie up so that the slackness of or loose steps can be tied up firmly here. And this is the platform where this vacuum box, blue box, is put over here. In the next step, I'll show you that. Here there are magnets also. At times nowadays, the magnets have become very popular. So at that upper level where accommodation ladder can be reached, at that level, the magnets are put and the straps are tied up so that the pilot ladder remains firm on it. Next one, we'll be talking about does and don'ts, so that you should know what is to be done and what is not to be done. Do and don'ts of the rigging. Now here you can see the peculiar deck of a cargo ship where you have got proper platform. But most of the time, now this is the place where all of the seafarers are making mistake. One, for not knowing the facts, and second, for the ease of convenience. Now you can imagine the paddle is here. You've got a D-shackle over here. They put another D-shackle to increase its length. And now this D-shackle has been covering the full pilot ladder rope. But now you imagine when it is holding, of course it will not let the pilot ladder go anywhere, but when the pilot steps on the ladder at a depth of 9 meters, the first thing, his weight comes on these shackles, and the shackles heavily get, the pilot ladder gets stretched, and these D shackles go hit the chocks, wooden chocks which are here. Now here you can see the latest ladder also. Nowadays they don't use that marlin to seize the wooden chocks here. It is directly metal strap is put here, and the steps are kept intact, so that they don't flip over. So this is not acceptable. So what pilot did, because pilot cannot make out how you are tied up here. So when he steps on it, he requests them to put another ladder, another rope from lashing point. So here you can see in the paddle at the deck, because these paddles and all are properly tested. That is why these things are given there. It has to have tested that. You cannot just rig anywhere, anything. So here also another small amendment is there, that you can see here the nylon rope. It has to be Manila rope only, because the bonding and the running reef which you put there will make it more tight and it will not let loose. So this is the running reef with the Manila rope. So practice this also, because tomorrow you will be getting, with the type of training and type of advancement in everything, we are overlooking all basic seamanships. Tomorrow a guy will come, probably he has come from the saloon, All these days he must be a GS, and suddenly for changing over his career, he has come down to deck deck crew. From there he has come many times. When I was sailing, one fine day, I was talking to one of my helmsmen. And then I realized that this guy was from galley. Of course, he had his efforts to come up to that level. But then when I told him to hoist a pilot flag, I realized he didn't know even what is halyard, for that matter. And he doesn't know what is up and down, how you put a pilot flag or which your flag for that matter. So these are the things which you all will be facing. As a new generation, you think he should know his job. But are you knowing his job? Because you are already supposed to know his job. So you just cannot get away with saying that, no, he should know his job. If he doesn't know, as we are teaching you, not that you don't know, but we are making more emphasis so that when you go on board, try to take interest in many other things also, not only pilot ladder. There are many other deck equipments. For example, when I'm also going as an external. So people cannot even name the various couplings, the hose couplings. They are making hands and showing me the actions, Ek aisa jata hai, ek aisa jata hai. So I said, what type of officer you are? Tomorrow if you want to indent such things, how you are going to indent? So the importance should be mentioned, and it should be, the education has to be imparted further. Not to keep it with yourself, because one fine day even you might be climbing the ladder. and then you will curse, "Arre, this guy has not done this, and because of which I became incapacitated." So this is another way where the acceptance is not there. Now see here, the iPad is there, but D shackle is nowhere in connection with that. First of all, it is not acceptable also. However, even if it has put, that also he has not done. And what ship's crew had done? He has conveniently taken that long rope here right up to the railing. Now imagine, the railings are not certified. They are only to give you support while walking on the deck. They cannot support your life. So that is another flaw here. Here you can see those masters and mates, they can try to see what can be the... I hope I have been heard, huh? Captain Karanjika?
Yeah, loud and clear.
Yeah,
loud and clear. Oh, okay, okay. No, because I'll be otherwise not knowing whether you are hearing or not. No, so no, anyway.
Go on.
Yeah, yeah. So here is the pilot ladder, you can see. And this bottom platform, which is again wrong. Now imagine pilot is climbing here. Now to step onto this platform, he has to climb his full height. And then only he can reach this platform. So the platform at 90 degree, first of all, he will hit this platform itself. And this is what, as a prudent officers, you should be checking. I have seen most of the time just seaman goes down or bosun goes down. He rigs it. The deck officer, he only sees from the top, standing over here. Yeah, okay, looks like good. It is attached with the pilot ladder. But he has not checked this platform. Platform has to be flat or parallel to the remaining length of the ladder. I mean, the accommodation gangway. Because that is the way it is. Here, this will first hit the pilot's head. And then pilot will have to do some gimmicks to climb up here. Because he will have to release this hand, take away from these railings and put it over here. And then he can shift up. So this is also again not acceptable. This is similar one. The ladder is going down. Many times these steps. Now steps are tied up here. See, is it a strong point or is it a certified point? Many of you will accept the fact if somebody can have this one enthusiast in such a height platform, try to slip down over here and look at the angle inside. You may not be knowing, it can be decisively corroded, because these are the another points which by and large it is overlooked. For the lipstick work, it is nicely painted green, fantastic, it is looking all sea green color and all, but you don't know the plates or the brackets, how they are. So these are the points. As a mate, take a hammer, chipping hammer, when you are going for the rounds, even, and you should know, because then that will make you perfect officer and then people will respect you. You will get respect only if you are knowledgeable. Many times you must have noticed, even we have experienced, there are masters who have done even 5, 6 years as a master, but some few basic things even they have missed out, because that is the lacuna, or that is the way they never have come across, or they may not have got opportunity to experience any type of things like this. So that is the one. Many times on the ships, because of the height of freeboard and all, the lashings and for quickness, because suddenly pilot is, okay, I'm coming in 20 minutes and all. So instead of tying up, the spreader is brought right up to the stanchions here. And spreader is resting on the stanchion. Now to see, so the ladder is safe, because this step can pass through the stanchions, but spreader cannot. But mind you, these wooden steps, they are only 8 kilonewton safe working load. And whereas the rope is 18 kilonewton, or rather 24, if I'm not mistaken. So your ladders, rather steps, are not supposed to take the full weight of your remaining ladder, which is hanging down about maybe 18 steps, and then the pilot's weight. So definitely, imagine if the pilot ladder is resting at this stanchions with the spreader will just break from this point. And without any warning also, it will just break by itself. So that is another point. Here also this lashing point is not correct, though this rope is correct, it is Manila only, but this is not the point. This is one of the few cases in the night, especially those railings which are of folding type, In this case, the railing has broken, so they have just kept it lied on the deck. And when the pilot comes in the night, he can get stepped into these other railings. So this is again not proper rigging, especially at the boarding, because once pilot boards on the deck, he has to have safe access to remaining deck, and then he walks through the deck to the bridge. This is on the tankers and all, you will see the pilot ladder for the short of manning and plus convenience. The rollers or the drums are kept at that, and the pilot ladder is fully coiled on it. So now when in the ballast condition, when you uncoil the pilot ladder, now see there is no connection between the deck and the pilot ladder rope. It is directly left onto the drum, which is not acceptable. And even if it is acceptable, I'll show you the few pictures further. In such cases only it can be acceptable. This one, the drum is not lashed anywhere, though it has got a lashing arrangement. What do you think? What should be supporting this eye and this eye with the D-shackle? Can somebody? Okay, I'll finish the suspense. This is the correct way. The bottle screw. I hope you know the name of this screw. Huh? So this is a bottle screw where it is tied up now. Now it will not let this drum accidentally unroll. So that's why it is marked correct. So this can be done. But by and large, the actual practice is you slack out the ropes, and on the deck where there are paddies, you lash it there. This is the compliant example. This is how it should be compliant. Or except for this nylon rope. There should be paddie, and the manila rope with the reef knot should be tied up here. Many times it so happens that officer forgets to check this portion. For the sake of lashing, the few steps are taken on the deck to ease out the weight over here so that the lashing can be completed. And thereafter, it is just left like that. So when pilot's boards here, suddenly these two steps get slacked and he gets jerked down below. And then he will come and claim or blame the master that it is not checked. So he can cancel the ship also, or ship can be detained for such things. And there will be heavy penalty and PNI claims, because in my case, once it had happened, similar way, the pilot ladder had just slipped off the two steps which were kept at the slack here. And then I got such a jerk that in the back, for 5 days I could not work. So I had given a note of protest and claim for this one, which subsequently I didn't go deep into it. But for ASM people who are going to be masters, make sure that your mate or second mate or third mate, whoever is watching or the rigging of it, he holds this staunchance. You don't have to send officer only, the crew also will do. So he holds this staunchance and he go and stands on this step and one step down. So that confirms that there is everything intact or the lashings are perfect. This is the picture drawn here from eye. There can be a little slack you have to give, and sometimes there will be step very close to eye. So you have to have some sufficient length of this rope, lashing rope. This is manila, which can be taken further up or even behind and can be tied up. And for this purpose, you have got these special ropes for the pilot ladder lashings. So you can put these D-shackles in this eye here, and then the remaining rope is free to lash the ladder as you feel convenient. So obviously when you remove all this, it has to go in the store. I can't expect pilot ladder to be in the store, but many a times I have observed pilot ladders are not even covered. As we as a cadets and all, we were taught anything and everything for the sea has to be lashed and covered, because the heavy seas, the rain, the ice and everything can damage your ladder. And just to show one small regarding the inspection of rope, I'll just go to another PPT and I'll just run quickly. This was meant for cadets actually. you know, for the training part. Yeah, it was just shown how the pilot climbs up and all. Can you see the importance of this? This is a flag edge, white over red. And this is the indication that if pilot sees this red color from the water, that means he is climbing more than 9 meters. Anytime if you see that many ships, they have this practice. This is basically practices brought through various observations and various incidences. Because in the night, pilot suddenly cannot assess everything. Though as a practice, he can come to know it is very high, but he might be busy climbing down from some other ship and all. So these are one of the arrangements made so that pilot, just at glance, he can know, oh, I can see the red, so I will not climb. Finish. Simple as that. So these bands are not for the fun sake, huh? Mind you. And this is, of course, how he's climbing. This is one of the, this one. Yeah. This is all you know, how the pilot ladder should be. 4 steps, each distance 310 to 350 mm. 4 rubber steps, then the spreader. Then 9th will be, every 9th step is a spreader. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Then this is a close look of how wooden chalk is tied up. This is the twine with which we used to do. And this is very intact, but this gets loosened up very often because of rough handling, picking up while picking up. So to avoid all those things, now they have started putting the metal strap as a clamping, so that it doesn't move here and there. Here, nowadays, you are lucky, as I said, the ladders are made out at workshops, and you are just get ready-made spoon feeding. This is the point I was talking about. From here, the ship's streamline is taking place. So this particular portion may not rest fully on the ship side, but anyway, depending upon how the pilot is boarding, by tugboat or by launch. So he will ask you to adjust accordingly and see how close the point of propeller here. Actually, this is right aster and propeller is somewhere here. So the moment he jumps, I mean, or falls in the water, the first thing he will get sucked into the propeller. This is another thing, combination. This also I have covered. Now this is the ground reality. The pictures and all are very rosy and all that, but this is how the shabby look of the pilot gangway. See how the pilot ladder is hanging. This man ropes are hanging and getting stuck between the ladder. Now this is the point where if man ropes are there here, as you see pilot has come up, you just ask pilot and remove this side, because when he's climbing here, he's invariably going to get fumble with this pilot rope. I mean, not pilot rope, man rope. So this is another point to be noticed. As an officer, this is the point I was saying, that this is actually not acceptable, but seems to be, or rather, it is actually a tanker alongside the berth. So in fact, I only have snapped it. So this is, of course, everybody is lazy. So I also didn't want it to climb little height of pilot ladder. So I said, sea is calm here, you can see. So I just come in the pilot launch only and I'll step onto the gangway itself. It is helping, win-win situation for both, for me also and for ship's crew also. They don't have to rig up after a whole night's work. So these are the few shortcuts we do apply. This also I've covered. Now this is very important in the inspection as an officer. Now see, this guy has taken full weight initially, and that is how you do. You must have seen the rigging, so that full weight doesn't come on you. That this is called tripping light. It has to lead always forward. And then this is correct way, preferably near the spreader, or lately I have seen very beautiful thing on one of the Filipino ships, cruise ship. They have made a small hole over here on the spreader. So the this tripping line is well clear from any steps, and the tipping line was hooked on to this. Here also you can see that pilot flag hotel. And now here what has happened? First of all, there is another point to rig, which ship's crew has not noticed. He has tied up here. Now see the connection between the gangway and the ladder. First of all, it can come closer provided this slack has been removed. It has been tied up so hard that the pilot step and pilot ladder is totally at angle, well away from the accommodation ladder. So these are the points which last moment you can't run around, you can't afford. Neither pilot will be liking it because he knows what is going and what is burning under his ass. So this is while rigging, now this is what has fumbled up everything. The lashing here, it has rope has stuck here, the ladder is like this. So these are all unwanted, you know, and this will cause heavy penalties and even detentions. And also as a ASM candidates, these are the points you must remember forever, because the first thing you, when you come to port, you will be interacting with pilot only. Here another merc ship, you can see the combination is well rigged, but the importance of strength of the pilot rope is not seen, and it has been parted here. Now imagine what must be the plight of pilot who is already hanging here. So that is it. Sorry. These are the two arrangements which I had already discussed, the vacuum blue box and the magnet. This is also already covered. This is the magnets, how they are being used. The magnets will hold firmly on the ship side. The strap will tighten on the both the sides so that pilot ladder, of course, this is shown very lower picture, maybe probably on the ships which are having less freeboard, but still, or rather, this is something unlikely because combination ladder cannot reach that height, because this has to be put by this one, the ship's crew. Probably it has been used by ship's crew from the deck level at the before sailing. This is another point I would emphasize on, that for small freeboards, I'm just going little 5 minutes extra, excuse me, last couple of slides. So many times what happens, unknowingly we leave the pilot ladder like this without realizing that the pilot launch is going to hit here. So it is always a prudent practice that after rigging pilot ladder, just lift it up with the tripping line, so that when the launch comes, even she doesn't have any hurdles, and she, once she comes alongside, just lower that steps down below so that crew from the pilot launch will hold it, and maybe they will spread it. If it is little longer, they'll spread it on their deck, and it will not get stuck with the eyes and hooks or the fenders of the pilot launch, and it will not break, because this is very crucial. If it breaks and all that, then you have a tough task to replace it. And that is all. This is the one of the ropes I wanted you to see. You have to twist the lay of the rope, and you'll find inside it is decisively damaged. One heavyweight pilot and it is gone. Even for that matter, this. See the chocks. How much gap it is. So the moment pilot steps on this, it is going to flip. And that's the end of pilot's life. And that's why, be safe and sure. Please remember, somebody's life is hanging on your ladder. So all the best, and I leave platform open for discussions. Thank you. Back to you, sir.
Thank you very much. Excellent. I mean, great. See, the questions are there. Let's see the questions. I think I saw some questions there.
Yes, sir. The magnetic clamps, is it a requirement by regulation or is it for practicality? That is one of the questions.
No, it is now going to be regulation. Already it is, but there are still, awareness is not there and it is not mandatory yet. But very few companies who are well-renowned companies, they are having this all practices done. Because see, first of all, especially in India, the mentality is the respect for life is negligible. I said it can be even negative. We really don't care even if somebody falls in front of you on the road, just with the fear that you don't want to get stuck with any litigies of it. So by and large, people are reluctant to have it, because again, anything you increase commercially, it is has to be viable for owner. Especially Indian owners, they will cut short everywhere and they will only concentrate on commercial profits. So at times you have to be firm. So, and that is one of the reasons why this on this platform we are promoting all these things, so that we can even take the matters to the owners also. Ship owners, ship managers are also will be covered slowly. So that is the reason. At the moment, it is not compulsory, but it is going to be. But by and large, in Bombay, I have seen 10% ships which are coming do have this magnetic magnets where you can tie the ladder. It is basically for the combination. On normal just ladder, if you are rigging, then it is not required.
It's not a requirement.
Yeah.
The next question is, many countries are against the use of man ropes, whereas some ports make it mandatory. And even while using man ropes in Australia, they want the open end and not the end with the knot to be down. What is the correct procedure?
Yeah, actually on this, there are different opinions. So it becomes port to port also. Like if you ask my experience, I have always insisted, especially in monsoon, I have always insisted to have man rope, especially while disembarking. Because imagine, I'll just share my view regarding this. When the pilot is climbing up, he has got more access to assess what is he's doing. Whereas when he's getting down, he's facing to the ship side, and down below, exact below, he cannot see. What he sees is the waves going forward. So he guesses with that, which trough and crest is coming. So especially in monsoon, before you have to be so active that with that particular moment only, when the trough is there, you have to step onto the pilot launch, because next crest is going to take you down by 2 meters, 2.5 meters. At that point, you cannot be very quick to keep sliding on the pilot ladder. And that is the point where I prefer to have a man rope so that I can just slide down, you know, and have support with me. Even if the launch I could not step on, I can hang on to the man rope. And with little gimmick, I can, like a Spider-Man, I can put my feet onto the ship side also, because the next wave is going to come and hit that pilot launch from me back from the down below. So that is the reason why pilots are fussy about having the lee. Because many times it so happens that pilot makes the lee, and with the little less experience or little less heart, as the close quarters are not experienced by masters every time. So as soon as pilot makes a lee, the ships which are at anchor seems to be very close, and obviously you are heading for them. But master doesn't assess properly that what is the speed. Speed might be only 4 knots. So for ASM people, you must understand with the speed as to what will be your reach in that much time. So by the time pilot goes down, it takes at least 10 minutes because he has to go through either ladder or the elevator and whatnot, depending upon container ships and so on. So main point was, I prefer that man ropes. But as you said correctly, because the monkey fist, now probably people may not be knowing the name. The monkey fist, that is the ball on the heaving line, which you have that ball, it is called monkey fist. So that can be hurdle on the man rope, which is lying down, because again, same thing, no ship's crew has to go up and down. So they care least about what exactly the rope they have lowered. So it might be such happens that the man rope can get stuck into the pilot launch fenders or anything. And because of that, in various ports, depending upon the sheltered area of pilot station, so they prefer not to have. As a regulation, it is still required, but it has been do away with also, subject to individual pilot or individual port also.
Exactly.
The main point is that it can be tripled, you know, the pilot can get stuck into that man rope also.
Yes. Yeah, sir. Just to add 2 bits to your answer, absolutely right. I mean, man ropes are absolutely requirement of pilots. Because there's something called, as you know, our shipping industry is not proactive, it's reactive. There's some accidents happen.
Yeah. In the we'll see then.
Okay. And okay.
Ball wait for on accidents to happen.
Yeah. Ball on the man rope. You know those tagons, the small tagons are there on the pilot boat, the pilot launch on the side?
Yes.
It
yes.
particularly has got stuck there many times. So even if pilot is in the boat and he signals everything is okay, and the pilot boat leaves the ship side, that band ropes gets pulled. It's a very tricky situation. Yeah, so they don't want any kind of this thing. There's another question to that also is tripping line.
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
Tripping
line. Yeah. So, nobody wants a tripping line to be there, first of all. Tripping line is basically a convenience of ship staff, ship's crew. Because when you want to pick up the ladder, you don't want to pick up the entire length of the ladder of 15 meters or 14 meters, 13 meters, whatever it is. So we have a triple line to take the load. Okay. So this tripping line is very, very important to tie up. It has to be tied up below the first trader. So all below your four steps or rubber steps are free. Because tripping line also has a history of getting stuck into the bits and fenders of the pilot boat. Imagine the tripping line is slackened and that gets stuck into the bits of the pilot boat, and pilot is climbing, pilot boat is moving away. What will happen? The entire pilot ladder will move away. And this has happened.
Pictures
of dangerous pictures. There's a Facebook group also called Dangerous Ladders. Be a member of that from today onwards. Now observe this. What all things happen in the world?
Initially, when I was a cadet, one day I asked Chief Officer also. I said, if we are going to pick up this full ladder from tripping side, might as well leave this head, no, which you are tied up on the deck. So, I mean, it was that sort of importance of the tripping line, because you are taking full weight one by one on that, and then this weight of the ladder gets released and it can be pulled inside by the crew.
Okay. How to decide whether we have to change pilot ladder or not? Is there any regulation to govern that?
No, basically, as I said, it is mainly the inspection, and that's why this ISM 10.1 is there, that regular routine inspection is there, and it is anybody's guess actually. You just imagine that you are going to put a step on it and see if you are feeling safe. See, there are safety margins, there are discretions. Now, if particular chalk is totally missing, then probably you'll have to do some temporary arrangements and put the chalk there, you know, so that, and provided the step is going to be used. Many times it so happens that the top ladders or top steps from the ship's deck side, they are hardly being used. They are only there to support the length of the freeboard, because pilot is going to board first maybe 15 steps or maybe 20 steps of up to first two spreaders. So this is all discretion of chief officer and master. If they think that it is not safe enough, just replace. And as you know, we have got two ladders on each side. So for the time being, if you are out at sea, just use another one. Or for that matter, you can request pilots also, because we also being seafarers and I have been master. Many times I have always thought about the thing, because when the ship comes to the pilot station, she's probably traveled last 6 hours. And before that, pilot, ship's crew and ship's officers might be doing tank cleaning, gas spraying, blah, blah. So I can well imagine, in fact, picking a pilot in the middle of the night is the worst thing to have. But with the tidal ports, you can't even avoid either. So it all depends. I mean, it is a master's discretion.
Yeah, but just to add 2 bits again, mine on this. Yeah. Pilot ladders are becoming very, very dangerous, guys. I mean, don't take any chances. Inspection of pilot ladder, you all are there, mixed candidate, masters also. Pilot ladders are the most trickiest thing, you know. So from 2012 onwards, as per IMPA regulations, the pilot ladder has to be supplied from ashore. So no taking any chance with the pilot ladder. Inspection has to be thorough. If it is, you think it is discarded, you please tell the company, sir, sorry, I cannot use this pilot ladder. Now discarding, there's... First of all, you should know what can go wrong with it.
What?
Wood, and the can crack. People are happily painting the pilot ladder steps. Please don't paint pilot ladder steps. Those can get brittle. The deck washers, the way the pilot ladder is stored. I'll show you some of the pictures if you want. I'll send it to the Anand sir. He can show it to you, give you the pictures also. The way they are stored in deck houses, they are half submerged in the water. So in this condition, Manila rope is supposed to show signs of breakage. That is why Manila rope is there. So understand, you know, apply logic. Though 799 gives you an exact picture of how the pilot ladder to be tested, 1045 tells you how it is to be inspected, But still, you will be able to use your common sense and say this pilot ladder is not good for climbing because that wooden plate will give, the wooden step will give cracking noise. The rope will be brittle. You can even remove by the upper strands by nails. I mean, your hand nails. Yeah. So don't take any chance with pilot ladders.
And if you see, I'll just like to add a point. The pilot steps, if you see, the holes are towards the end side. So the earliest point, or rather the weakest point, is that with little rough handling, the steps will just break it there, because two different holes on both the sides. And from there, if you see the edge of the step, it hardly has any margin. And that's why those chokes and all has to be formed there. So many times it so happens while picking up, especially the lower steps near the pilot launch, as Captain Karanjikar also said, they get crushed between the pilot launch and the ship side. If you are leave them loose well in the water without caring for the freeboat. See, when pilot launch, I mean, when the control tells you that pilot launch, I mean, pilot ladder to rig above water level, say 1.5, 2 meters. So that is a specific reason, because that is the freeboard of the pilot launch. So that freeboard can be little overlooked. So one or two steps, because last moment may you cannot lower the full ladder, which is nicely lashed. So in such cases, you can have two steps extra. But as I said, pull up with the tripping line and let the launch come alongside and nicely lower it, so that it will save your work also and last moment running around also.
I think it's a very interesting and out of the box question. With so much of hurdles, okay, regulations and competency required in proper rigging of pilot ladders, why can't we have a system developed by pilot vessel so that continuous maintenance is possible and will be more safer also? Pilot will be more confident to use and will be very familiar also. Why can't we develop something like that? It's like using tug lines.
Yes. Yeah, it is a good question. But what I will say is, you are going to come or become a pilot only if you are going to become a master, which is a basic requirement. So obviously you have gone through, now you have seen the other side of the coin. Now you will appreciate as to why pilots are so fussy. You have to, especially I'm talking about talking to master's candidates, that you must, as a master, now you are more into administration. So you must understand the human psychology. Just like, as I said, ki, I have been master, I really don't make any fuss about all that, because I imagine myself also to be on bridge. So I have been quite lenient about few things. I overlook certain things, but there are pilots who has not been as a master. So they will just go as per books. As you have seen in the Gulf surveys and all, they are just bookworms. They have seen some picture somewhere and they expect everywhere that same item should be there. I remember when I was second mate in the Gulf, that safety inspector had come and we had that extinguisher, which you can plunger and break it. So it had that U-clamp in between for a lock pin.
Lock.
So yeah, so he had seen somewhere in the book where there used to be a this toggle pin.
Okay.
No, it has to be a toggle pin and like a locking pin and also this, and that is why we are come into this, because many times unless you go through certain things, you will not appreciate what is the problem or what are the uses of it. So what you are saying is correct, but the type of ships and different type of arrangements on the ship, you can't have a uniform method. And that is why we are training the ship's personnel. Because tomorrow, if I go to, cable laying ship, probably many of you have not seen even. So cable laying ship has got its own peculiar arrangement for pilot ladder. Certain ships, they don't have arrangement, especially for Navy ships. And plus in the port, we have to pilot them because we are using our tug. So there, though, they don't have any arrangement because their regulations are governed totally different. They being of forces, they don't have all such categories. So we sometimes have to, at times they are literally pulled up, you know, of course on the small freeboard, but the deck crew pulls up because they can't have all that. And neither for once in a blue moon things, they cannot have the arrangements because that is their different ship structure and requirements. Is it clear? I mean, whoever has asked that question.
Yeah, very true. I mean, correct. The question is very out of the box, because this is what the entire IMPA, AMPA, and all the associations are thinking in the world. What can be the alternative to pilot ladder? The alternative to pilot ladder in Australia is helicopter. Okay, simple. But helicopter also has got a plus and minuses, and you know, the pros and cons of the entire system. So far the pilot ladder has been good, you know, because it was being made on board, the seamanship was at par, people would repair it, could tend it. Now, since it's coming from ashore, we don't know what quality it comes through. The certification is required, but it is manufacturer certificate, not certified by class. So some manufacturers, they get certified by the DNV and IR class and all that. And to tell you, this is Sri Kumar, that we are going to run next year a competition among the all MTIs, inflate minds kind of stuff, to present it to international media and shipping media, of course, shipping circles and, you know, so-called IMO and organizations, as to what alternatives can we bring in to pilot ladders in design, in construction. You know, it could be anything. So you please be take part in that. You know, when we want to have suggestions. If you're seeing, by and large, I mean, you've been a mate and second mate and all that. By and large, when pilot is okay with the alternative like gangway, you know, crane basket in dry docks and things like that, pilot will prefer those methodologies. So even pilots don't want to climb pilot ladder because it's risky. So everybody understands risky. But under dynamic conditions of boarding at pilot boarding ground, and you know, I mean, you won't believe, in Calcutta port, when the boarding used to be in sanded earlier, there used to be one accident every day. Because in sanded, you couldn't board. The 3 meters swell. The people had to be really like, you know, cliffhangers or kind of those, you know, Spider-Mans, I mean, inside. Go and jump on the parachute and catch it and then start climbing it. So I mean, yes, sir, of course, it is a very good question.
Yes. The next question is, onboard ships with elevator, some company or master's policy says that pilot to be brought by steps only, whereas many pilots insist on elevator usage. Is there any guidance by the pilot association?
There is no guidance as such, but simply the master is approaching the port. You know, he doesn't want pilot to get stuck into the lift because of your power failure or because of lift failure or darwaja band nahi kiya and all that stuff, you know. So he must want the pilot to be as soon as possible on bridge because on he can bridge. Hold hand and, you know.
No, but another angle can be that master must have been harassed somewhere in the ports by some pilot. So he must be taking revenge by not allowing. I mean, as a pilot myself, I can't find any excuse why he should not allow me. Because especially on container ships, it's 9 high. So you can't expect pilot, because pilot has to reach on bridge as soon as he can, because he has to take over thereafter. So if you allow him, by the time you go up, he is exhausted. He will say, okay, captain, continue dead slow, and I'll just take rest for a while.
Correct.
So, I mean, it cannot be insisted on.
This speaks volumes about the master confidence on his equipment.
So the pilot will first inform PSC that there is something wrong with the ship, because he has not allowed me to use the elevator. A joke apart, but yes, it cannot be done, because you can't expect certain heights. Yes, normal bulk carrier, and where you don't have arrangements, there is no alternative. Now, as I said, now every day at least 180 meters up and 180 meters down we are doing. So if I do 6 ships for 24 hours, so it's 180 meters up and down. And now by now I must have done at least, I'm talking about big ships, about 10,000 in last 14 years. It can be even much more, including small crafts. It is with every pilot, of course. Every pilot has to have such a history to boost about.
Fine, understood.
So,
anything else?
Anything else?
Yeah, some countries pilot comes on tugboat to board vessel and ask for only gangway. Freeboard is still around 9 to 10 meters. Should we follow pilot orders or rig combination?
No. If pilot has advised you, by all means, you lock down in your VHF lock. That is the first important thing, because he knows what is the height of, or rather the freeboard of his tug. So he has calculated all that. And as I said, even pilot tries to cut corners, you know, we, as soon as he can board, it is more better and he will not have to climb the vertical distance. You're stepping on the ladder is always, I mean, the gangway is always easier than stepping onto the ladder. So it depends. I mean, even at times, because what happens, that particular tug has gone for an escort also, especially for deep draft ships or something like that. So he might as well, the port also finds convenient, instead of sparing a launch, they say, okay, you go take a tug only, you board. So it is like win-win situation. Even the ship staff doesn't have to do the exercise of rigging.
Rigging. Okay. One question. In many ports, pilot board near to breakwater only. Thus, very little master pilot exchange possible. Any rough sketch of a port, probably transverse mitigator projection of the port, is better to be used for master pilot exchange. Have seen such good practices in some ports. Such exchange to be implemented in all ports.
Yes, I mean, we insist on all that. But as you said correctly, that there is hardly any margin. When you are already near breakwater, you are already onto the maneuvers. Tug will come, he will tie up and blah, blah, blah. So there is hardly any exchange of this one. But if you have a other point of view, that probably that is not much required, because if he's coming so close to the breakwater, that means either the port is very limited berths or very less anchorages in the area. And by virtue of which, it probably, except for the communication equipments and other equipments data, but the maneuver as such can be on the run can be done. Because by and large it happens, because you can't really spare, you know, for many times it looks very rosy that, okay, captain and pilot, as they show in video, they are exchanging. So that really doesn't happen, because pilot is already trying to take the feel of the ship. And that is the skill of pilot, because probably he has come down from some supply boat and suddenly I'm climbing on the Suezmax. So the feel of this maneuver and feel of the engines, many times there are habits of, or rather the purposely they will not tell any deficiencies, which of course beforehand only we get the this one from the master written confirmation that so and so things happen. But still there are times, especially in the old ships, that they will not disclose. One day I remember in middle of the night with the following tide, I was coming inside the port, I was going for a designated anchorage, it was a spring tide. And I knew that I am coming closer. So first thing I did was, because from the beginning when I was asking master to slow down, he was only saying yes, yes. But he has already crossed the pilot boarding area and he was still coming in. I said, okay, now at least stop, because I cannot cope up with this speed. My pilot launch speed is not that high, 7-8 knots. It is just 4-5 knots. So he stopped there. And then by the time I climbed up, I was close to the required anchorage area. So first thing I did was I gone astern just to break down the momentum. And then when ship came down in a controllable speed, I stopped engine and then I gave next moment. And that's the time master comes and he whispers in my ears, like, pilot, I cannot give you more than 3 kicks. Oh, hell. Now imagine middle of the night when there is another traffic following me. There is another traffic coming out from ahead and this guy is telling me, captain, I cannot give you more than 3 engines. And that too, first engine will be after 20 minutes. So this is where then my teaching experience came to the handy. I just said, okay, captain, let go anchor. Right in the channel, I let go anchor and believe me, the flood just flipped me out, you know, and she got stopped because the flood tide was on and tide was on my stern. So it just flipped and I was rock steady. I immediately informed on VTS to harbor control that such and such thing is there. Now let all the traffic pass, then only I will move from here. So then of course it has become embarrassing for other deep draft ships also. They have to squeeze between that channel and the anchor ships and all. But these are the occasions where you have to be having very brave heart, you know, to take the shocks like this, the sudden shocks. So that way, I mean, the maneuver cannot be really discussed, you know, sitting on chair and on table. So while talking to master, we keep describing him, like, okay, you take a tug on the bow with the tug line and hereafter we'll be turning to port or starboard or which swing we are taking, because it all depends on which side we are going to go alongside and so on and so forth. You know?
True, true. I mean, just to put add two bits to this, MPEX, that is called as the Master Pilot Exchange, has become a big topic of debate now. Because in many accident analysis investigations has come out to the light that the MPEX was not proper, you know, and 3 minutes, 7 minutes are no MPEX things. So most of the ports, including Indian ports, soon will launch now the MPEX to be done 24 hours before. In fact, AMPA is carrying out a campaign, safety fortnight campaign in 4 ports in India, and from December 1st to December 15th, where we will do the, for only 4 major ports for time being, and then 4 major ports in March and then June, like that. So all these ports will have the MPEX done 24 hours before. When master requests pilot, he will have to send the complete particulars of vessel, the vessel's passage plan, and the equipment condition and declaration that everything is working fine with the pilot and certified and all that. And the port planning officer or port planning department will send back the port passage plan to the pilot, to the vessel, for compliance. This is going to happen. MPEX is watch out this thing. This is going to be a big thing in coming future.
I think the rest of the questions are all one way or the other repetitions. So we can.
Captain Anand, there is one question from the YouTube, from one of your.
Yeah.
Mr. Madhav Sharma has asked, sir, why embarkation ladder doesn't have spreaders?
Embarkation ladder?
Yeah. I think he's talking about the life.
Lifeboat.
Yeah, lifeboat embarkation ladder.
Because you are going to leave them, you know. You are going running for your life. So there is no probability that you will again climb that same ladder. So it is just to run away from the ship. It will become cumbersome to lower the embarcation ladder.
Yeah, correct. And also because curvature of curvature of the ship. The spreader will not.
Curvature is there with the lifeboat space. Exactly. It will not serve the purpose.
Yeah.
Spreader is there to stop ladder from twisting. So it can only be useful and optimally used when the pilot ladder is not on the ship side. When you have a curvature, it will not help. It will be, in fact, obstruction while lowering the, or while throwing the pilot ladder, embarkation ladder down.
Embarkation ladder.
Yeah. I think we should conclude. Final remark for me as such. Thank you very much, guys. And I believe you have been, you had the enlightened last 1.5 hour on pilot ladder and procedures. AMPA is organizing one special webinar, and which is called as reconceptualizing the Indian pilotage, maritime pilotage. And this is for the webinar for government and the ports as to what we can do in our pilotage and why what we can do and what world has done. So we have called in some international speakers, including of Chirp Maritime UK, Jeff Parfit and Captain Ravi Nijjar from Australia, and one Simon Measures from Australia. There's one harbour master of Newcastle, Australia, Janine Drummond, Captain. She will also join the webinar. The idea is to brainstorm the modernization of pilotage things in Indian pilotage, where the pilot ladder alternative also will be discussed. So the thing is that a pilot ladder, pilot transfer procedure, and a pilot training towards safety of navigation in port. Because the entire ambit of all these are parts of the safety of navigation in port. If tomorrow pilot doesn't board your vessel, when vessel is inbound at 8 knots, 10 knots at pilot boarding ground, or 6 knots, in fact, with master having no local knowledge, no charts to navigate inside, it's an absolute dangerous situation. So what we are jeopardizing is national monument, national port security, environment, people, everything. So that's the thing, what we are looking at, safety of navigation. Pilot ladder, we do it with the air because this is something which is very close to your heart and your work on board vessel. I always call it, after Captain Oak's lectures, this is prime. He primes people. So PRIME, the P stands for proper ladder, certified ladder. You know, R is the rigging procedure. There has to be a proper rolling hitch. There has to be a proper strong point. And chief officer, you must ensure that whoever ties the ladder, you must supervise it. It doesn't take more than 5 minutes to supervise the ladder. But your eye, your master also can fish can see the pilot net tying up. Number three, it has to be inspected after rigging up. Very important. I. M, it has to be manned by somebody. 24. Pilot ladder, you cannot leave it like this. Whether pilot is boarding or not. Because it's again a security matter. It is in your security plan of the vessel. So every ladder hanging outside has to be manned. And importantly, E in the prime is that it should be able to do efficient transfer of person from boat to the vessel. So it has to be efficient. So since you all have been primed now with the knowledge, I am sure that 130 ships will be, you know, safe pilot and save lives. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you all.
Thank you, HIMPians, Sanjeev Vakil, and the principal sahab, Anand sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much
from MPA as well to you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for this lecture.
And just as a token of appreciation, just one more.
Okay, Anand, I have it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Chat box, you can register from that link. You can share it with the students.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Thanks.
To Captain
Duncan. Yes.
Oh, okay.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much.
So, should we call it a day now? Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Sanjeev. Thank you, Captain Gajanan. Thank you very much.
Okay. Bye.
Yeah, can I suppose a word of thanks?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.